Thank you. Now, first of all, I do want to address some of the late night rumors that are out there. There are some rumors that Dave will leave CBS, and you know, people kind of want to know if I would be interested in taking that spot, or maybe Dave doesn't, or maybe I'll take, you know, the spot at ABC. But I just want to clarify about those rumors. Yes, I would. I would do anything. I would do that one. I would do Dave, Leno, Conan. Anybody wants to leave? Willard Scott, you tired of waving at old people? I'll take that. I'll do whatever you. I work on basic cable. Do you understand what I'm saying? I'd like to get some of those spoiled rich guys over to my neck of the woods where you still have to pay for your own sodas and your show comes on after 3 Andrew McCarthy movies. Do you understand what that's like? And not the good ones where the mannequin comes to life, the bad ones. But I had fun. I did the Grammys last week, but it left me with a very interesting question. It did leave me with a very interesting question. Are Justin and Brittany the before and Kid Rock and Pam Anderson the after? Does anyone know? But now I'm back in New York and I'm delighted to be. I've lived here 15 years and I love it here. And, hooray. Hooray for having an apartment. I still feel safe here, you know? Probably because in my apartment, I have that chain that goes from the wall to the door. Because you just put that on at night, and that just says to terrorists, "Hey! You're not getting in here unless you push with your hand." But it's an exciting time to be in New York. St. Patty's Day Parade coming up next week. Yes. It'll be... They're already... drunk for it. That's exciting. The St. Patrick's Day Parade, although it is a little controversial, gay people are not allowed to march in the St. Patrick's Day Parade. But let me just explain something. I know that's controversial, but gay people are very flamboyant. And they can't march in that parade because you don't want anything to distract from the dignity of that parade. You understand what I'm saying? You don't want some gay guy checking you out while you're whizzing on the side of a building. I don't know why people so they fear the gay agenda. Gay people don't seem to want all that much. They want to march in the St. Patty's Day Parade. They want to be in the Army. They want to march in the St. Patty's Day, be in the Army, get married. You know, it's not that big a deal. Why can't gay people be in the Army? What's that about? What's the Army afraid going to happen if gay people are in it? Private, shoot that man. I can't. He's adorable. You know what I think the Army's actually afraid of? 1,000 gay guys with M16s going, "Who'd you call a faggot?" And they can't, what is it? Is it, they can't be in the Boy Scouts? I don't know who the Boy Scouts think they're kidding. I mean, come on. The Boy Scouts is already the gayest organization in America. The definition of gay isn't same-sex intercourse, it's thousands of young boys wearing neckerchiefs. Eagerly awaiting next year's jamboree. Even the village people think those outfits are gay. What are they afraid of with all that? I mean, sexuality is what it is. Do you know what I mean? It does. People can't convince you to do that. I've got a tape of a guy having sex with a piñata. I think, or maybe that's how they get the candy in them. But it's not, you can't talk people in and out of that stuff. You just are what you are. Your mind can be changed. Your heart can be swayed. Your penis is very stubborn. I'm telling you. I mean, if you were driving home and you passed a pumpkin field and you got a little tingling, and then the next night you drove past the pumpkin field again and you got another little tingling, I got bad news for you. One night, you're banging a pumpkin. And they're not gonna get you to pray it out or do it. You know, they always got that thing, "Oh, we'll put the Ten Commandments up. That'll fix everything. Put the Ten Commandments up. That'll stop school violence. Oh yeah, the kids will come to school. Oh, thou shalt not kill." Oh, God. If you think putting the Ten Commandments up is gonna stop violence, then you think employees must wash hands is keeping the urine out of your Happy Meal. We got a great show for you tonight.